This is Ham Radio. Okay, start the music, Gary.
This is Ham Radio. I don't think I did that right.
So we're going to just move right on. This is Ham Radio Now, episode number 461.
The most important amateur radio program on the internet. I am Gary Pierce, K4AAQ, the King of Ham.
And I'm David Goldenberg, W0DHG.
I'm Natalie Gray, a.k.a. Glam Ham Radio on TikTok. And my call sign is November Whiskey 6 Sierra. And I am coming to you from behind the Hollywood sign in Los Angeles. I was scouted by Warner Brothers for this incredible project, which I haven't been allowed to speak about for nearly six years. And I can finally tell you, I've been a writer on Hogwarts Legacy, which is an amazing epic video game that's set in the Wizarding World, and it comes out February 10th.
You're sitting in the writer's room, and you introduce the line, and Harry picks up his BaoFeng. It was a dark and stormy night, because of course it was. And it was a showdown between Harry Potter and his arch enemy, the evil Lord Voldemort. And on this night, Voldemort had the upper hand. He was raising his wand and about to utter an incantation that might spell the end of Potter once and for all. You know the word. I just can't bring myself to repeat it. Potter reached for his wand to defend himself, but it was nowhere to be found. Voldemort had torn it from Potter's hand with the Expelliarmus spell just moments before. But Potter had one last trick up his sleeve, or on his belt, to be more accurate. He reached down and grabbed his trusty BaoFeng handy-talkie, the one with the extra capacity battery and the extended length rubber duck antenna. That rubber duck had actually selected Harry rather than the other way around. He had acquired it from the secret radio shack in the back of Ollivander's wand shop in Diagon Alley in London, where it had practically leapt from the shelf onto Potter's radio after scrounging an adapter because it had actually been designed for a Yaesu radio. Pulling the BaoFeng from his belt, Harry Potter quickly tuned it to the most powerful repeater in all the land, the repeater that sat high on the summit of Mount Belzoni, with solid coverage of the entire metropolitan area, and well beyond. Potter raised the BaoFeng to meet Voldemort's level and firmly pressed the push to talk. Electrons rushed from the bowels of the extra-capacity battery, converted themselves to RF in the oscillator circuit, and were amplified to a full 8 watts in the final transistor before coursing down the extended length rubber duck antenna and leaping out in a burst of radio frequency energy the likes of which Potter had never experienced. Before Voldemort could complete his spell, the radio signal from Potter's BaoFeng handy-talkie crossed the space between them, striking the evil wizard square in the chest. Voldemort dropped his wand and was knocked flat on his evil wizard arse. Harry Potter, with his 8-watt BaoFeng handy-talkie with the extra-capacity battery and the extended rubber duck antenna, had won, because of course they had.